An outdoor industrial slab in Memphis, Tennessee, is being closely watched as a pilot project for internally cured concrete.
It's definitely the first internal curing project of its type in Memphis and in that portion or that part of the country.
Located at Fullen Dock along the lower Mississippi River, this 52,000 square foot slab is one of the largest outdoor holding areas ever built to utilize internally cured concrete.
When Fullen Dock decided to put this new slab in their facility to store our material, we worked with them and with the ready mix producer to get internal curing into the concrete mix. We helped the ready mix producer with the mix design, and we were on site during the placement of the concrete to make sure everything went as well as possible.
The first batch of concrete was poured on a cloudy, cold morning in December 2013. Air temperatures were hovering just around the freezing mark, and the concrete was down in the 50s.
Both of those temperatures are lower than you would like them to be. Internal curing gives the concrete a better chance to survive less than ideal conditions during placement and immediately after placement.
Early strength tests reflected the less than favorable placement conditions, but that changed as the concrete cured. Because it contained pre-wetted lightweight fines, water absorbed by those aggregates was slowly released over time. At 28 days, the concrete strength ranged from 4,200 to over 5,400 PSI.
So the internal curing did its job. It helped the concrete survive.
Big River's Jeff Speck says with internal curing relatively new, this project has a number of industry experts closely watching the outcome.
People are looking at it and they want to know what difficulties, if any, did the ReadyMix producer have in producing the concrete. And what we found on the Fullen Dock project was that the ReadyMix producer had literally no problems producing the concrete. It did require a little more vibration on the sand bin to get the pre-soaked lightweight aggregate to fall into the wayhopper, but other than that, he had no issues with the lightweight material.
The contractor placing the concrete was also pleased with the performance of the material.
The contractor had no problems. The concrete placed well. The subcontractor who did the sawing of the control joints commented he was able to do the saw cuts in less time than it would have taken without the internal curing.
Riverlite, manufactured at the company's Irwinville, Louisiana plant, is distributed via Fullen Dock's Intermodal River Terminal to customers in western Tennessee, north Mississippi, and Arkansas. Speck notes his company is particularly impressed with the Fullen Dock's ability to unload barges in almost any water condition.
We operate a number of terminal facilities throughout the central and eastern part of the United States, and Fullen Dock is by far the premier operator when it comes to a barge terminal location. They're able to unload barges in very low water conditions as well as very high water conditions. Really doesn't matter to Fullen Dock.
The massive steel-reinforced 8-inch thick slab at Fullen Dock will be used to hold Big River's lightweight aggregate prior to being loaded into trucks for delivery. Big River expects the new concrete holding slab to stand up to heavy traffic, resist cracking, and service its needs for decades to come.